Yo, King of the Dot, put your money where your mouth is. Ground Zero, Toronto, make some noise, y'all. I am your host, Organic. You can follow us on Twitter at King of the Dot, at Organic Hip Hop. Make sure you go to KOTDTV.com, order all the pay-per-views and shit that we do. I got a bunch of co-hosts, starting with the homies.
Bishop Brigante, check me out. Follow me on Twitter at Bishop Brigante. Peace.
Yes, sir, it's your boy, Arcane. Top of the food chain. The new name is 2 Chainz. Shout out both of these motherfuckers, man. Shout out Scandalis, OG, repping this shit. I'm waiting to see this battle. Let's go.
You did, Gully TK, man. I've been looking forward to this shit since we set it up. Let's go. Let's make it classic. You did?
This is slow.
Royalty Auto Spa. I'm in the building, man. If you need a car for a video, hit me up. Hit King of the Dot up. I'm here supporting King of the Dot. Sure. I wouldn't know any of these rappers, YouTube, not YouTube, if it wasn't for these two right here. Put your hands together for these two men. There's a lot of you rappers that probably wouldn't be known as well as you are today if it wasn't for these two. Let's do it one more time. Put your hands together.
Shit. Rapper to my right, introduce yourself.
Yo, it's Tycoon Tax, man, that new nigga coming up. Yo, shout out to Scandalis for stepping up. You know what I mean? Legend in the game. We're going to make it a classic tonight, man. We're going to get it, man. Get this chicken.
Get that chicken, nigga.
Making his return to the battle scene, rapper to my left, introduce yourself.
The call me Mr. 200 rounds, the call me Mr. 200 rounds.
Let's go!
Alright, Tycoon Tax won the coin toss. He chose to go first. Hold it down. Last battle of the night. Let's have fun. Toronto, let's go!
Yo, I say, Scandalis. Out of retirement. Crazy, right? So what you got? Some rounds that are gonna break me down to the core? Well, I got news for you, homie. It wasn't retirement. Nobody gave a fuck you were around anymore. Mm-hmm. Scandalis. Bunch of videos on YouTube with no views because they all suck. You fat, dirty nigga. The only clean thing about you is that you washed up. Oh. You old and crippled, plus no one missed you. The Empire ain't even repping you like that. And I heard you roll with cops. Well, you better hope the force is with you when I blow this pistol just to see if the Empire strikes back. Oh. And his government name? Tony Ranks. And in the top 100 rappers in Toronto, on the bottom is exactly where Tony ranks. Matter of fact, I should hit him with 50 and take Tony Yayo with the Iron Man like Tony Starks. See his fiends, sell him all E, or catch him on his grind and give Tony Hawks. Spark in my hand, I ain't holding a lighter. Just know I don't miss like a Soviet sniper. He said he copped this, he said he copped that. We all know Tony's a liar. He said he got stripes because he's a serial killer. Well, I put him in a box early. Now he's Tony the Tiger. What's crazy is, you went from rapping for funds to rapping for fun. But what'd you expect? He's fat. He was supposed to have a short run. So when Organic gave me you, I was skeptical about the choice, because he a rat. He the type to sing soon as you turn your back, like an episode of The Voice. And I heard they kicked you out of Empire. I guess they felt like you make better tracks when you dead, cause in 2010 they jumped you and broke a bar stool on the back of your head. Now against Kaliente, I talked about him being homeless. I feel like it's time for me to remix that. Cause being in one of the biggest crews in Toronto and literally getting kicked out, dog, for real? That shit's whack. I should let a sick clap where your ribs at, or have my niggas stomp you out, but it looks like your own niggas already did. You don't wanna see me.
You don't wanna see me
masked up in a black van, hitting anything from the quip to the trash can. You get eaten in the dot, and today I'm Pac-Man. You'll see through him when I put a body on this machine. Bishop, I told you I had something for this cat scan. You're done.
Let's go.
Welcome back.
Hold on, first of all.
All right.
Yo, don't call me Scandalis no more. Call me Gandhi, or Mr. Tony Ranks if you ain't squad or family. And I'm back in this bitch like Marcus Camby, cause your rapper is inorganic and your boss is angry. What we have here, and you're soon to witness, is a battle between youth and wisdom, between new and vintage, between truth and fiction, between a rapper that just acts and a dude that lives it. See, I don't believe what you write about you skiing the white. You want to see serving fiends making G's every night? Nigga, please, you and Kaliente, if he is alike, because he's homeless, and you never held a key in your life.
You're right.
I'm really from the hood, welfare checks and food banks. You're only in the hood when you're connecting a new amp. Now you're dealing with a veteran, a legend, a true champ, that's about to give this youth a lesson from boot camp. Man, watch the scheme, watch the scheme. I get weed from BC, see niggas, they will front packs, but it gets helter-skelter if you don't bring their funds back. Don't load Smith & Wesson's buckshots at this young cat and his OG sees that you'll never make a gun clap. So stop fronting like your bus, Dax, young Tax. I'm in the streets like a hubcap, trust that. Matter of fact, I run rap. My flow is dope like cheap coke, dope like cheap coke, dope like cheap coke. They were hoping that I come back. I can get you whatever you wish, from the deadliest piff to ketamine bricks. Say that raw cocaine if you're ready to sniff. I don't need the internet to get you plenty of fish. And I can even get you play some hard rock, but you don't want that work. You're faking all talk. That's why my niggas be taking y'all chops, your tax, but your fiends get H on R block. That first round was a snack appetizer. Next round it gets KO, cat tranquilizer. Tony.
I know you probably mad at the information that leaked out in the first round. Storm. I'm sorry, dog. I had to check you like a credit score. But you know all that information's true, because I got all that information from a close friend of yours. You know, the same close friend that punched you in your face because you were something like a fiend. You were part of Empire, but you were nothing but a queen. Empire was popping too, and you stopped fucking with your team. You jumped ship to row your boat. Now for you, life is nothing but a dream. You're a fucking cokehead. I know I said something similar to Kaliente, I had to bring it back for a sec. Cause when Loaded Luck said, you gon' get this work, Caliente's homeless ass sent him a resume, right? And this nigga Scandalis started scratching his neck. Once again, you're a fucking cokehead. You don't care and it's sad. So I'ma take your wig off for living that addict life like Roger from American Dad. And I'm a fucking girl. While you sniffing 8 balls to escape, but in the end you just like your girl. You're both known for taking balls to the face. So I hear you from Gordon Ridge. But niggas told me if you stepping back there, you're getting robbed. Cause you talk about putting work in, but you were never on your job. 2 burners, I let them spit till they click like Tim Horton's lids. You'll be on IV like Hovis kid, with your tongue sticking out like Jordan did. I show up on your block where your homies live, and start extorting kids and turn Gordon Ridge into an orphanage. So just chill out, or get your white tee tie-dyed in seconds. You better roll with the mob and have wise guy protection. My goons are masked up at the sci-fi convention. Come to the west, my block is a hot spot like a Wi-Fi connection. Funny how he's old school, funny how he's old school, but I taught him a lesson. Every word's chosen perfect. I got this size down to perfection. So today, you're getting nothing but bars. Don't worry your eyes out of aggression. Matter of fact, I changed it so you like it. Today, you're getting nothing but lines. See? Now, why got his attention? You've been rapping for 7. You've been rapping for 10 plus, with not one sign of progression, not one deal on the table. Now, my God, it's depressing. You got paid for features, about $5 a session. While you was doing that, I was working with Max way before the iPod was invented. Let me get this straight. You 32 and decided to jump into battle rap. Alright, cool. What did you stop sniffing and start smoking or something? What the fuck is your plan, Scandalis? To be top tier by the time you're 40 or something? What's crazy is I'm even standing in front of you despite all your accomplishments and our age difference. You 32 jumping into the game. You Blake Griffin. But I heard when they fucked you up at Toby's, you was hiding under cars trying to phone your homies but couldn't find none of them. So I take that back. He's not like Blake Griffin. Cause he jumps over cars. You hide under them.
Young buck sock. You pitiful bastard. You got punch butt. No difficult patterns. No biblical wit. You typical bastard. I will cripple you quick. Just figure your staff up. I will flip you like reciprocal factors. You ain't fucking with Scandalis when I'm ripping in the battle. Fuck, I fucked up.
Hold on, let me get back to it.
Sorry, let me do it right. Sorry, I got a little hype. Sorry. I ain't joking, though. No. I take fucking that. Y'all young bucks suck. Y'all pitiful bastards. You got punch butt. No difficult patterns. No lyrical wit. You typical rappers. I make syllables flip. Reciprocal factors. I will cripple you quick. Just figure your backup. You should pick up a bitch for picking this matchup. You got style, but you're missing the passion. I'm giving birth to the north like Kimmy Kardashian. Ooh. I rap nice. Ooh. Get used to it. Are you crack's wife or his groupie chick? Tycoon Tax is a white new jack that's on crack's pipe like Pookie's lips. I'll scoop your bitch, get her loose off the juice, and use her hips. Put your youth in the tooth, abuse her kids. For the stupid shit, she'll get used like a mule. Have the food that we move, she be hooping it. But you glamorizing gangster life, when you really should be advertising faggot rights. You Luciano crap. Hold on. When you should be advertising faggot rights, you a Luciano crack, be holding hands at night, watching Magic Mike under candlelight.
Oh my god.
So mind you, stop claiming you're a shotter. Pardon my French, but I know Haitians that will fight you. You're just another actor that be waiting for an Oscar. You only lit a Mac up when you're waiting on your doctor. Shit, it's getting late. I should have made my move. My last 16 should have had you 8x2. Peace.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Hey, he got chicken, Zach. Chicken, man. I say, yo,
three.
I go, third round, I ain't wasting no time. You wanna jump on my dick, Scad, start waiting in line. You 32, just started, dog, you ain't gonna shine. You old Toronto, you Cardinal official back in the day, dog. I'm Drake in his prime. What's crazy is, you were buzzing at the same time as Drake and didn't get signed. You probably secretly pissing him, ain't you? There was 100 artists just like you at that time. None of you were fit for a label. Don't get it twisted, y'all paved the way. Don't think I'm ungrateful. But what I'm trying to say is if y'all weren't gonna eat, then why the fuck would you sit at the table? Let me get this straight. He gets kicked out of Empire, goes nowhere with music. Now he's a legend? Nigga, you only respected where you at. GPS wouldn't help you if you lost today. You still irrelevant in rap. Nobody on the globe knows you. I'm just helping you remember all the facts. So y'all tell me, how the fuck is he a legend when he was never on a map?
That's crazy. That's crazy.
I don't give a fuck tonight. We can fight, Scan. I throw a bullet and your man will scream behind you since he wanna be a hype man. Or I drop some money on your head and shorten your lifespan. My young goon, I'll grab the gun and put the red beam on you. Right, Scan. That was my first cocaine business. You could've told me I got dimes for sale. But he's in denial. He'd be the type to be like, nah, I don't like cocaine. I just like the smell. Trust me, Scan, this kind of drama ain't on the TV. You ain't gonna see me banging a DE aimed at your beanie. So for acting Tony, you gon' down real life. You James Gandolfini.
Listen, let's go.
I'll fuck with the Bulls. I'm
John Gotti. Marlon Blue, bitch.
Yo, myself, B. Myself, hey. I'm fucking doing my thing here, myself.
One more time. Let's go.
James Gandolfini, bring it back.
I got this, man. Listen, I don't fuck with the Bull. I'm John Gotti, fam. If I catch him slipping, it's the right and the left that I'ma probably land. Make him empty out his pockets. Soon as you see that shiny scram, he gon' think we at the airport. Cause if he don't empty out his pockets, I'm gonna have to body scan. You ain't heard? I'm blowing up. I'm coming with C4. Two bodies in one night. Crack, what does the team score? Four bodies in a row. Why you fucking with me for? Best performance every event. Am I right? So organic, where the fuck is my matchup for WD4? Let's get this shit, man.
MA gang.
He's gonna slap the shit out of you.
All right, guys, keep going.
That ain't happening. Wyatt! You talk about my life like you lived it. You talk about my wife like you hit it. Since you like to talk about my life in your lyrics, is it cool if I talk about my life for a minute? See, I'm just a product of this world we grow up in. I've done a ton of shows, but made all my dough hustling. And I hate the hustle. Every hustler owes something to someone. This game will shut you out for nothing. So I'm gonna keep it real this round. No fluffing, no bluffing, no huffing, no puffing. Just pure substance. See, I lost everything trying to earn something, and what's the point of speaking words if nobody learns nothing?
Real shit.
Yo, Socrates, philosophies, and all of these religions, they all could see and all agree that all should be forgiven, but the laws of these democracies that got me in the system, they robbed me from my property and locked me in a prison. They ran up in my house like some home intruders, looking for that weed like the road to Ruder, for some coke that I stashed in an old computer. Thank God that identified my loaded Ruger. Shit, that was like the third time they hit me. First time at Lansdowne, second time at Christie. Then a wise man said some words to this dude. Then a wise man said some words to this dude. He said, what you know ain't working, you should learn something new. Education's inspiration, man, his words were the truth. He was feeding my mind while he was serving me soup. And honestly, I'm sick of the system. I'm sick of these bitches. I'm sick of being on bail with different conditions. I'm sick of only seeing my family when they visit this prison. I'd rather be free, spreading infinite wisdom. So I went back to school, trying to educate myself. Find some legal ways that I could elevate my wealth. Lost a little weight, I'm trying to celebrate my health. Nobody pushed me, I perpetuated self. That's why you should respect my style. Tell you the truth, I'm on house arrest right now. You are literally standing in a father's prison who was doing an 18-month conditional sentence. But my PO gave me permission to give you this lesson. But my PO gave me permission to give him this lesson. It's coming right out. Just give it a second. If I only said it once, I never said it enough. You should never look down on any man unless you're helping them up.
Wow. Hey, make some noise for Tycoon Tax.
I slipped on a second, but it was...
All right, so it's Nameless with that beyond the judging system for a fantastic non-judged battle here. And we've got two guys who are highly regarded in this scene. Scandalis, who I know both of us grew up in that freestyle shit, like back in the day, fucking rapping with this dude.
Yeah, you already know.
Major difference between that. And Tycoon himself, he's been on some insane momentum. So I just wanted to talk to these guys a bit about this battle here, because I know, like, when I came in from the written format, we're two guys who did the freestyle shit beforehand.
Exactly.
And made the transition into this written shit.
Yeah.
So I know, like, for me, I put a lot of thought into how to make that transition. Mm. And I just wanted to talk to you guys about, like, you know, how do you write for someone who doesn't have a battle with the written format? How did you feel about that preparing?
Well, just from the jump, I knew Scandalis himself was a legend. I've been seeing him around the scene for years now, you know what I mean? Like, since I was coming up doing my thing, he was coming around, you know what I mean? I knew he was a legend, so when I heard that he was going to be my next opponent, I just prepared for him like he was the greatest. I treated him like I was battling Logan Lux.
Right.
He didn't have material for me to study, but he just has so much background information that people just know about him that it was enough for me to just do my thing.
And Scans, I know obviously you have like a whole fucking library of tracks yourself that are written material, and you've got a lot of experience on stage through battling. Well, how did you kind of prepare for that transition from that kind of freestyle improvised era to the written shit that you're doing today?
I'm actually like, how I prepared was, I forgot about a beat. You know, I always write to a beat, but you know, people said time stretching. You know, I watch these guys, they stretch their bars across. Like, emcees don't take it lightly. Like, to do this shit is hard work, man. It's easy to slip when you like putting together these writtens on an acapella tip, but I just wrote from like flipping some punches, doing some schemes, some multis, you know, just trying to show some skills with it. That's really it.
Yeah.
I didn't know shit about the dude. Literally, I didn't even check what his Facebook was, nigga. Like,
this nigga's lying.
I watched it. Hold on. I watched like a couple of his videos on YouTube.
Here it comes.
But I didn't know you like that. I never heard about you until nigga said I'm facing you and I want to check your battles. I'm like, yo, this kid got skills, so you know. I better come tight, you know what I mean? So it was pretty dope.
So you talked a bit about like the nerves of this, you know, reciting something versus making it up. Like when, I know you slipped up a bit, I think it was in the second round. Did you feel like one thing is a lot of the time when we saw some other slip ups tonight, and when the slip up happens, they just kind of fell back and you saw their confidence go down. Yeah. Whereas I felt like you made a good recovery from it. Mm-hmm. Like, it didn't feel like it was over at that point. Did you feel like the momentum was shifting there? Or how did you feel about that?
Definitely not. He has the advantage because he's a legend coming back. He could have done whatever he wanted in that second. He could have just talked some shit. Like, this nigga pulled out the bail papers and everybody would have been crazy. You know? Nobody even seen that. He could have done whatever he wanted. But like, I guarantee you.
That's the fucking realest prop I've ever seen.
That was me that would have choked in the second. My momentum would have been gone out the door. I wouldn't have not been able to continue. I can't afford to choke, but not to say that he can. It's just that just there's so much hype around him.
Did you feel like it was an uphill battle today for you? Or did you feel like because you have experience in this avenue that you had the like?
I had a slight advantage. He just has like he's been doing it in front of hundreds and hundreds of people on stage on freestyle. Do you know what I mean? Like I do have a slight advantage because I'm good at the written format. But he just has advantage just of just rocking shows.
I slipped in my second. If my second came off, you would have been over. What's all
good? He's honest.
Leo, real talk. Like it's just the memory and the format of how it works. But you know what? Like this is not my last one. You know, it's my first one.
So. To speak to that, like obviously, I think it sounds like you're interested to come back. Is there anything you want to take from this battle and bring into the next one? Anything you learn from today?
Don't over pattern yourself. You know what I mean? Because one word slipped and then I lost it for a second. That's the whole thing. The pattern was so complex and one word went off and I'm like, wow.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? Like you got to simplify it more time. You know, like set up and punch. But you know, I try to do combos. Yeah. But I'll study for the next time I come in. It'll be dope. You know?
Let me just say something quick. I just want to say about both of these dudes, Tycoon Tax and Scandalis. Scandalis to me is definitely an OG in the game. This dude, I mean, like back in the freestyle era, Scandalis was that dude. You know what I mean? We had a couple battles ourselves. We battled a couple times. Dope battles. Tycoon Tax.
I won.
You won. I beat you one time too. I think we went one and one. But still, always one of my favorites. One of my favorite OG freestyle MCs in the scene, man. Tycoon Tax has been coming up in the game over the past couple years, and I've been watching his shit, and I've been watching his progression, and he's really made a lot of improvement over the last, just the last year. I've been watching his battles, and I see a drastic improvement. His bars are there. His delivery is there. Everything is just the full package is coming together. So I feel like going into this battle, I feel like Tycoon Tax actually did have a bit of advantage over you.
Yeah.
And I'm just saying that because coming from the freestyle era, I had a hard time myself transitioning into this written format, and I feel like you do in 2013 have to try to bring more, you know, heavy schemes like you were talking about the multis, and sometimes those multis can trip you up. You know what I mean? If the scheme is too crazy, and that's where, you know, more practice at it with the written format. You really got to memorize. It's not like when you battle back in the day, you don't know who you're really battling on that day. You're just going there to rap. Whereas in this day and age, when you know who you're battling and you have so much time to prepare for your opponent, you got to do the work. Like Tycoon Tax obviously dug up some dirt and tried to use whatever he could to put it together. You know what I mean? And that's in this day and age of battle rap. It's a much more fierce game than where we came from, but your blade is still sharp, man. It's great to see you back. It's great to see you back, man. And you know, Nick, straight up, man. And even whatever, you had a little bit of a slip up. Respect to you as well, my man. You had a bit of a slip up in the one round, and that was like, you know, it's tough to see that because I've had a couple chokes myself in battles, and whenever I see another, there was a couple tonight, a couple MCs that choked, and whenever I see that, just. Come on, but you brought it back well, man, like a pro, like a fucking vet, and that's what's up, man.
Yeah, no doubt. Finished it out. It's
proper,
it's
you know, so I respect that. That battle was dope on both sides, man. I'm real happy to see that go down.
Yeah, that's that, man. It's a fucking legendary battle. It's nice to see all these legends coming back, and I just hope we see more guys from that era, because I know, you know, there's lots of guys from our era that I think are still sharp with the pen.
Let's bring Bishop back next.
Let's bring Bishop back.
Let's bring Bishop back next.
Theology 3, Decisive,
all these guys from the era. Let's bring them all back. JD era, where are they, man?
Exactly. Good shit. Peace.